On behalf of IDFC Securities, I would like to welcome you to the Q2 FY19 earnings call of Dixon Technologies. The management is being represented by Mr. Atul Lal, Managing Director, and Mr. Saurav Gupta, CFO. I'll now hand over the call to Mr. Atul Lal for his initial remarks, post which we'll open up the floor for Q&A. Over to you, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for taking out time for this call. Before we go to the Q&A, I wanted to share the snapshot of Q2 performance. Due to the consolidated revenues ended September 30, 2018, was 741 crore rupees against 881 of the same period last year. The reason for this lower revenue on year-on-year basis is there has been a 23% decline in the revenue of consumer electronics. This is primarily because of two reasons. One, there is a shift in Diwali in this year, and the LED television tends to peak around Diwali. So there is a shift from October last year to November this year. However, in spite of that, there has been a volume growth in this quarter. Mobile business, which has been significantly lower by 55% on year-on-year basis, that has dragged down the revenues further. Lighting business has been flat. There has been a growth of 1%. But this is primarily because of a significant decline in CFL, which has practically come to a stop now. We take out the CFL business, there has been a year-on-year growth 15% in this year on the lighting revenue. The consolidated EBITDA for the quarter was 35 crores as against 37 crores in the corresponding period last year. It's lower by 6%. However, the margins have seen an expansion from 4.2 to 4.7% this year. This is primarily because of the expansion of margins in the consumer electronics vertical from 2.4% in Q2 last year to 3.6%. This is again mainly a higher migration of ODM, the ramp up in Tirupati plant almost maturing now, and also backward integration in the LCM line. The consolidated PAT for this quarter is 16.4 crores against 21 crores in the same period last year. The profitability this year has been impacted primarily because of the depreciation of rupee and the volatility in the commodity prices. Now, I have always been assuring that we are having a fairly risk-free business model. Now, the business model that we have is that we pass on any impact of the currency to the customer as per the contract, which is either monthly or bi-monthly or three-month basis. Now, usually there has been a parabolic kind of a change in the commodity prices and the currency. But unfortunately, in the last 3 months, it's only been an increase. So that has been a drag on the profitability, which has impacted significantly. Now, one, it has stabilized lately. And second, we've come out with some internal mechanism and some contracts are being renegotiated. So I feel that we'll be able to take care of this issue to a very large extent in the coming quarters. In all the verticals today, we have now built a very large capacity. So the operating leverage issue, the operating leverage advantage would start kicking in all through. And in all the verticals, there is a significant migration to ODM. So that is another significant step forward as per our strategy. So now I'll take you through the performance and the strategy in each verticals going forward. In the consumer electronics division, as we shared that the revenue this year is 360 crores against 466 crores last year, again because of Diwali shifting. However, the operating profit margin has expanded to 3.6%. That is 13 crores against 11 crores last year. So it has expanded from 2.4% to 3.6%. The ODM percentage has increased from 5% to 10%. The backward integration of LCM and the closure of the Dehradun LED TV unit by which we are having duplicate cost structures has been already taken care. One very significant positive in this quarter has been the acquisition of account of Xiaomi by us. Now, Xiaomi has done exceedingly well in the smart television segment. It has already reached a market share of more than 10%. It is a leading smart television brand. It's having already a number one position. So we already started clocking a sale of 15,000 to 20,000 per month for them. And the order book with them in the coming months is extremely, extremely healthy. We have created a capacity earlier of 2.4 million at our Tirupati plant, which is being expanded to 3.4 million now, that is 2.9 lakhs a month. And this expansion will be over by December this year. So this increased capacity will give us a share of almost 24% of the Indian market, which is the largest capacity any company, any unit has in India. Further, we are have deepened our manufacturing facility, both with LCA, manual insertion, and SMT. So the depth of manufacturing today is the same, if not more, than any other multinational company or any other company in India or globally. So the second, I wanted to go to the home appliances segment. In home appliances, there has been a strong revenue growth of almost 79%. So we did 104 crores in Q2 18-19 against 58 crores in the same period last year. In Q2, we have sold almost 2.1 lakh machines against in 18-19 against 1.3 lakhs in the same period last year. However, the operating margins have contracted by almost 360 basis points. This is again primarily because of the depreciating INR and commodity cost. This again has been a very special kind of a situation where it has been continuously increasing. So lately I'm seeing the stability there. And we have worked out on internal mechanism and some renegotiation of our contracts to take care of it with our customers. In washing machine segment, again, we have a very, very healthy order book. Our anchor customer, Samsung, from January 19, is doubling the volume. And then from June 2019, it's going to be again another edition of another model, which will take the volumes to almost 500,000 a year. Large account that we have added is Lloyd's. So we feel very confident and we feel that it's going to be a large number for us. So we are likely to grow by 30-35% as far as volume is concerned this year. We are confident about it. As far as the lighting segment is concerned, the revenues have grown by 1% this year, 190 crores against 188 crores last year. The conventional CFL business has come to a stop. Adjusting the revenue of lighting CFL business, the revenue growth would have been 15%. However, the operating margins contracted by 110 basis points from 6.9% to 5.8%. This is again mainly on account of volatility in the commodity prices and depreciation of rupee, which had a bearing of on the raw material. Also, there was some ramp-up cost because we have really added some new customers towards the end of August, September. However, on the yearly basis, so if you see the first half, our operating margin is 6.7% in the current fiscal against 5.5% in the corresponding period last year. So in lighting segment, undoubtedly we are the largest today in the country. We have a capacity of 15 million per month against the Indian requirement of around 32-33 million. So that's more than 40% of the Indian requirement. In the month of October, the month that ended yesterday, we have clocked the sale of 13.5 million bulbs, which is the highest. We have practically all the brands today with us. So the new brands that we have added, apart from Philips, Panasonic, Bajaj, Wipro, is Orient, Ajanta, Siska, Polycap, CNA, Jaguar, Usha, all these are our brands. And all of them have migrated to the ODM solution. So further in this particular vertical, we are getting a significant traction from the global players for exports. So I think some of our large anchor customers are going to take us to the global market. further, we are also confident that in the next fiscal, we'll have a couple of large accounts for exports in LED bulbs. What we've been able to do in LED bulbs, we are consolidating our position to do the same thing and follow the same strategy for battens. So we are ramping up our capacity, and we are now engaging new customers. So various new, almost all the customers that we have in LED bulb, we have a window there for battens, and we are very, very confident that these customers are going to be with us in the next couple of quarters. So the run rate of battens, which was at around 300K, we're very confident that we're going to take it up to almost 1.5 million in the next couple of quarters. So the whole position in lighting as a vertical is looks very, very strong. We have already implemented a backward integration plan of mechanicals and inductors, and further backward integration in mechanicals is going to happen, which should have a positive impact on our margins. Mobile phones has been a drag. There has been a decline of almost 55% year-on-year because of a low capacity utilization and our customers not doing very well in the marketplace. The operating margins in this quarter at 0.9% against 1.7% a year ago. However, the margins were flat at 1% year-on-year basis if we consider the whole first half. So as I had shared in the last call also, we are in advanced stages of discussion for some new accounts in the mobile, and we expect the quarter capacity utilization to significantly improve from the current quarter. We have also implemented a backward integration plan for PCBAs. So the lines have already been installed, and the commercial production for PCBAs is going to start in the current month of November, which will definitely help us in improving both our revenues and our margins. The next is security surveillance system, which is a new vertical. So the commercial production already started. The expansion from a capacity of 1.5 lakhs to 5 lakhs per month of digital cameras and 30K per month to 1.5 lakh per month of DVR has already taken place. Our JV partner is Aditya Infotech, who owns the trademark CP Plus, the HUA, and he's also the brand licensee of Panasonic, doing exceedingly well. In fact, we are further increasing our capacity, and that will happen by December. But the capacity is going to be 9 lakhs per month of cameras and 150K of DVR. This is going to be the largest Indian capacity. Now, this business from the current month of November will turn profitable. So the capacity utilization is starting place. The SMT lines have been installed, and it's going to be operative. It's already become operative now. In the reverse logistics segment, there has been a revenue. It has been lower by 59% year-on-year. This is primarily because of lower account, lower capacity utilization, because of challenge in the set-top box business. So, although we have been able to turn on the corner, and we have delivered a positive EBITDA of 12 lakhs. Here, the main focus is more on the LED TV repair business. We have acquired new accounts. In fact, the latest account that we have acquired in panel repair business is of Xiaomi also. So the main focus would be there, and this would also be in line with our strategy of providing end-to-end service for our customers. So that is what I wanted to share with you on every vertical and the company's performance in the last quarter. Any questions, please, they're most welcome. Thanks.
Thank you. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We have our first question from the line of Aditya Bhartia from Investec. Please go ahead.
Hi, good afternoon, sir. So my first question is on margins in the ODM businesses, which got significantly impacted in Q2 on account of rupee depreciation and higher commodity costs. Now, from what I understand, contract negotiations take place at average pricing of the period and not on period-end pricing. Does that mean that margins in the next couple of quarters could also remain lower than usual?
you are absolutely right to a certain extent that, of course, in the ODM business, it gets passed on with a lag. I can give you an example without naming the customer, that suppose if the contract with the customer is structured on a 6-monthly basis, and the average of that 6-month dollar turns out to be, say, 68-69 rupees. And so when your next negotiation, once you are able to pass that 69 rupees, by the time that dollar is already moved up to 72-73 rupees. So you can only pass on to the extent of the older, you can partially pass on. So as Mr. Lal had mentioned earlier, so if the dollar stabilizes from here, then I think so we will recoup some of the margins going forward. But if the dollar continues to move at a similar rate, what it has been in the last 6 months, then I think so we will have a situation which you are seeing.
However, to add to that, we are working out on some internal mechanism for sourcing in different currencies, which is going to dilute this impact. We have worked out on some internal mechanisms for hedging and buyer's credit. So there might be some impact, but what has happened in Q2 because of the currency depreciation, I feel in the subsequent quarters, if at all that impact is there, it will be much more diluted.
Sure, understood. But given that, let's say you would have been able to pass on currency only at 68 or 69, vis-a-vis what it is day-to-day, 72-73, could it still mean that in something like washing machines, margins would be maybe high single digits, low double digits over the next few quarters, until the next negotiation cycle comes into play?
For what you're saying on the washing machine business, you're right.
Okay, understood. The second question is on Xiaomi LED TV revenues. What would have been the contribution from Xiaomi in Q2? And how do you see this ramping up over the next few quarters? Also, just wanted to check if...
It has been very insignificant. There's hardly anything. So we just started. The present run rate is around 10 to 15,000 sets per month in October to December. Let me assure you, the order book and forecast much, much larger. I don't want to share that number, but it's much, much, much larger.
Okay. So for the remaining sets, Xiaomi is importing currently?
Yeah, they're doing CPU imports.
So, Aditya, we are the only manufacturing partner for them. So either they are importing or getting it manufactured from us, which gradually, as we have a strong order books in a couple of months down the line, I think so the more and more imports will keep coming down and more will get transferred to us.
Okay. And a related question, you mentioned about the increasing capacity on the LED TV side to 3.4 million. Now it's substantially higher in comparison to, I think we did around a million units last year. So what kind of visibility are we seeing on the LED TV side? I thought that even the capacity that we were already having would have sufficed for at least next year and a half.
There is one as I shared with you that Xiaomi is a very large forecast. The way they have been able to ramp up the business is amazing. Meet their requirement, need this capacity. Second, we already have various new customers. Practically all the brands today, whether it's Flipkart, various retail chains, TCL, TCL sub-brand, Falcon, EPL, Diverth, another brand, Metz, Lloyd, a new brand, TPB has acquired, the China company, Philips. Many more in the pipeline are there with us. Second, as I shared with you in my opening remarks, in LED television as a segment, it tends to peak around Diwali.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever is the normal requirement, the requirement around Diwali is around 50-60% higher. So we have to gear up for that.
Okay.
And in any case, this is not a very high capex or a high fixed cost business. So I think it's extremely prudent to have this capacity, which has already been done. And be absolutely geared up for servicing the customer requirement.
Understood. And lastly, sir, one of your customers, Crompton, spoke about setting up its own manufacturing facility to control costs on LED lighting side. Do you see the risk of some other larger guys also opting for their own manufacturing?
I don't think so. I don't think so. Because I've named practically all the brands, the top 10, 15 brands in India, are all there with us. In our order book, as far as lighting is concerned, is overflowing. I don't see that trend. There are some brands. Compton is one that I've also heard. Second is Havel, they do it in-house. Other than that, I'm not seeing any brand looking at in-house production.
Understood, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Rahul Agarwal from ICICI Prudential Life Insurance. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. My first question is on the washing machine. So, incrementally, Samsung is adding a lot to the growth in terms of volumes. But is it that Samsung actually is turning out to be a low margin for us, or that the margin mix is pretty similar for Samsung?
So, Samsung is comparatively a slightly lower margin business. However, we are doing significant value engineering, and we feel that another quarter or so, to a large extent, we should be able to improve the margin in that business also. And the new models that are being finalized with Samsung, the margins are going to be much better, as good as the other businesses.
So when we say Jan 19, we are doubling our volumes from Samsung, even June 19, there will be an uptick. So the margin profile should not be very much different from current margin profile.
So I feel that from January, I mean, in this particular fiscal, the margin improvement will not be very significant. But from Q1 next fiscal, there will be a margin improvement. And the new model introduction would be at a better pricing.
Okay. So my second question is on the CAPEX. What is our CAPEX plans now for FY19 and how much have we spent on?
Yeah, so our CAPEX has been in the range of almost 38 odd crores in the first half of this financial year. And I think so, as I mentioned, so our CAPEX has been mostly front-ended this year. So I think so H2, the rate of CAPEX will come down. So at an annual level, I think so our CAPEX should be somewhere around between 50 to 55 odd crores.
Okay. And for next year, sir? Hello?
Hello? Yeah, Rahul?
For the FY20, sir?
FY20, it should be in the similar range of 55 to 60 crores.
Okay. So my last question is on this net debt figure. So from March, when we were net debt free, we have now turned to a net debt number after the fundraise. So exactly how should we look at this number from here on? Has it peaked or is it you are expecting some more increase in it?
Rahul, this is an aberration. Let me just share with you. This number will keep on coming down. You'll see this number coming down in this quarter and further coming down in the next quarter. This has primarily happened because of front-ending of certain CAPEX and migration to ODM across all our verticals. However, when we acquire a decent scale in our ODM, we are able to negotiate significantly better terms. And also, we should be able to improve on the debtor. So you'll see this situation significantly improving in this quarter and the next quarter.
All right. Great, sir. Thanks a lot and all the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nitin Arora from Axis Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon. With respect to Xiaomi, which you're saying that they will do some 15 to 20,000 units and the order booking would be much higher going forward, whom you think he will start eating market share from? So is it going to be the guys, four guys who's holding 70% of the market, Samsung, LG, Sony, or is it the guy who's a 10% share in the market like a Panasonic, which is your client? Just want to take on that.
So Nathan, he will eat the market share of all the top four players, including Panasonic as well. So the Samsung, LG, Sony, and Panasonic would get affected.
So how is Panasonic doing as of now for you in the TV, and how much you expect he softens out? So at the end of the day, we even out, right? A Xiaomi goes up and a Panasonic goes down. So can you give a more clarity on that?
So Panasonic with Xiaomi will definitely be under pressure. But as far as our volumes of Panasonic are concerned, there would be a small impact, but not very significant impact. But Xiaomi add-on will be much larger. Will be much, much larger than any minor impact that would happen on Panasonic. Because, as you very correctly mentioned, one feels that the impact of Xiaomi, just like it has happened in mobile phones, is more on the top brands. And second is, they are only launching the smart solutions. They're not into the conventional solutions. And Panasonic 75-80% is conventional solution.
Okay. Because sir, we were seeing that on the ground, that is the lower end, which is the 20-30% of the market, getting more impacted by Xiaomi entry. So rather we'll see in the coming as you guiding us. Can you provide us the volume numbers of lighting, consumer electronic, washing machines, mobiles and camera CCTV for this quarter?
I can share that number with you separately, or you just want the numbers right now? Then
it's possible. We just want to see how much EBITDA per unit you're making across your category. So, I mean, that's fine if I can take it offline also.
Actually, the volume
numbers are benefit for everyone. Okay.
So slide 11, the volume numbers are already there. Is there anything specific that you're looking?
Sure. I'll take it from there. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Abhishek Ghosh from DSP Mutual Fund. Please go ahead. Abhishek Ghosh, your line has been unmuted. Please go ahead. As there is no response, we'll move ahead. Participants, if you have any questions, please press star and one. The next question is from the line of Jagannatham T from Centrum. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for taking my question. One query is, can you throw a bit more insights on mobile phones business and such a sharp drop in terms of revenue as well as there is a squeeze in terms of the operating profit margin? And what can be the trigger for changing of this trend? I mean, are you seeing any possibility of this thing to get revived?
Sorry, can you just repeat the question? I'm not able to...
Regarding mobile phones, there is a clear drop in terms of revenue as well as operating profit margin. Is there any trigger that that we can foresee where probably this trend can change and things can improve?
Yeah, so as I shared with you in the opening remarks, we have already implemented our backward integration plan. The SMT lines for PCBA, on which the Government of India has imposed a duty, have been installed. Now, this capacity in the industry is very limited. So, very many brands, I'm not in a position to share the names of the brand as of now, have already placed orders on us. This is significantly going to improve the margins. The second is that Joni, which was not doing well earlier, has been taken up as a brand licensee by our partner, Jaina. and this is being relaunched. So there's an uptick there. Third, we are in the process of negotiation with a large brand in India. Again, I'm not able to share. It's slightly premature. And I'm very, very confident that business is going to come to us in this quarter. So one is very confident that the mobile business from the current quarter would significantly turn around.
And the dip that we are witnessing, is it because of one particular customer or is it across the customers there is a slowdown in mobile phones?
Some of the customers that we were, our main anchor customers had not done well, namely Panasonic and Sony. So the uptick is going to happen primarily again because of two reasons. One, the backward integration being implemented and fructifying in this current quarter. The second is addition of new customers who are already large players in this market. So both these things are going to add both to revenue as well as margins.
Okay. One last question is, considering now home appliances growing aggressively and mobile phones, there is a dip. Maybe in the next 2-3 years, do you foresee that home appliances will be the major driving force? And so how do you see, I mean, in terms of this product mix eventually, let's say in the next 2-3 years?
We feel that across all these segments, the penetration level in India is small. Second, the government policies and the costs in China, really ballooning, all this consumption of India is going to be serviced from through India manufacturing. Third, more and more brands are focusing on branding and distribution, and the manufacturing and designing part is being outsourced. I feel across all these verticals, there is a significant tailwind. And in some of the verticals which I shared with you, like lighting, there is a huge potential for getting into the global market.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Abhishek Ghosh from DSP Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity, sir. So sorry to harp upon the net debt thing again. If you see from March 18 levels, our net debt has increased by almost about 68 odd crores, while we have also generated a fair amount of cash profits closer to about 40 odd crores. So given that working capital is stable and we have done capex of only about 40 odd crores, why should this net debt figure go up? What am I missing?
This is primarily because of increase in the ODM business. Now, washing machine, the increase in the revenue is almost 80%. This is all ODM, which requires working capital. Similarly, if you see the consumer electronic business, the LED television business, the share of ODM has increased from 5% to 10% in this quarter. And also, this is around the peak period. It's primarily because of these two reasons. Second, of course, there has to be much more focus on the management of the current assets, that both stocks and debtors. So it's a combination of three things. And let me assure you, this is an aberration. It will get corrected in the current quarter and in the next quarter.
Okay. So is it a fair assumption to make that about 40-50 crores of working capital would have gone into from March levels?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much and all the best.
Generally goes up in the festive season, so that is also one of the reasons.
Fair enough. But this time I thought Diwali you mentioned has got pushed back, so I thought that
should
happen.
But your components start coming in, you know.
Sure. Your investment into the business goes because you need to be ready for the Diwali season.
So you have not built it as of now, but you've already procured the same, so it's still in.
You're building the inventories and invested into the stocks.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Akash Jain from Ashcon Global. Please go ahead.
Sir, I wanted a color on this brand Marque, which is launched by Flipkart. So how are the volumes taking up in that brand?
Marque is the private label of Flipkart. At present, the volumes are not very huge. But I can see a lot of focus from their side on this particular private label. So I think over a period of time, they will attain a decent volume. At present, what they're sourcing from us is around 7,000-8,000 sets a month.
Okay. Okay. And
now for masks, we have also launched washing machine.
Okay. Okay. And with the Xiaomi coming in picture, is there any exclusivity clause?
For Mark?
No, for us to manufacture other company products?
No, there's nothing of that kind.
Okay.
Clause.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nishit Jalan from Kotak Securities. Please go ahead.
So just wanted to check, what are you hearing from your main customers in consumer electronics and home appliances segments in terms of...
Nishit, you have to be slightly louder.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
So just wanted to check, what color are you getting from your key customers in consumer electronics and home appliances segments in terms of how the festive is ramping up and how your order book is kind of shaping up?
I'll share with you segment by segment.
Okay.
In consumer electronics, overall, the kind of growth that was expected in Diwali has been muted. But in our case, we have a healthy order book because of new customer acquisition. The various names that I shared. So it was Xiaomi, of course, and beyond Xiaomi, the various new names.
Mm-hmm.
In washing machine also, I find the demand has been not as per expectations around Diwali. It has been slightly muted. That is the case. However, in lighting, I am seeing a very, very robust demand. And even for November, that's the month after Diwali, I am seeing an extremely healthy order book. So that is the situation.
So just a follow-up, when you say muted Diwali in consumer electronics, you mean is there any growth, low single-digit growth, or there decline?
I don't think there will be a decline. Mm-hmm. I think it will be a low single-digit growth.
Okay. Thank you. That's it from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pankaj Cholia from Elara Capital. Please go ahead.
Thank you for providing me the opportunity. I have a few questions on the consumer electronics business. How much was the Diwali sales booked in Q2, like from the Navratri to Diwali sales?
Sorry, can you please repeat the question?
How much would have been the Diwali sale booked in Q2, like from the Navratri, it started at 10th October. So probably like how much would have been booked in Q2?
So last year, would the whole sale of Diwali would have been booked in Q2.
And this year, it would have been like...
Our customers, they in turn have to be shipping to the various retail outlets.
Okay.
There is a 10-day time between our dispatches and what reaches the market.
That's right.
So last year, everything was booked in Q2. But this year, a large portion would be booked in October for Diwali.
Okay. And within the consumer electronics segment, can you share me the TV volume?
Yeah, so TV volume, out of the 6.7 lakh quantity that we have shown in the presentation, TV volume is around 4.2 to 4.3 lakhs.
Okay, and last year, corresponding quarter?
Last year, it was a similar number.
It was a similar
number. It was 4.5.
Okay. And is this margin in the TV business sustainable at 3.6%? Or do you think that it can improve?
Quarter three, I think so the margins which should be sustainable in the TV business should be somewhere around 3-odd%, sub 3 or marginally higher than 3%. Okay. I think 3.6 also factors into account slightly impact of better sales. Lately, so I would say as far as modeling is concerned, you should factor a 3% kind of a number.
Okay. And one final question on for the TV business, like how much would have been the total assembly out of the total TV assembled would be the LCM assembly as well?
So we have presently assembling almost 60 to 65% of our TVs as LCM. But the idea is to take it up to 100%, so we'll keep inching up towards 100% gradually.
But in Q2 numbers, the share of LCM is around 40%. We just started the LCM assembly sometime in July.
Right.
It's taken some time, and now almost 70 to 80% of manufacturing will happen along with LCM. By November end, our surface mount lines are going to get installed. The motherboard assembly would also start from December. That's what the plan was. So LCM has been stabilized, and almost 80-90% of televisions along with LCM would be done. From December, a large chunk of motherboard would also be done in-house.
Okay. And so one final question, like how is the import substitution playing out in TV business and lighting business? Because of the increase in the import duty?
Now, let's say televisions, all the brands, the duty is 20%.
Yes.
There is a significant advantage of manufacturing in India in this competitive category. I'm looking at producing in India. So, it's only a ramp-up issue. Very sure Tommy also will completely shift to India manufacturing. As far as LED lighting is concerned, particularly the indoor lighting, all bulbs are practically manufactured in India. Patterns were being imported, but the duty hike has happened.
This is the operator. We have lost the line for the management. Please hold while we reconnect.
Thank you.
We have the line for management connected. Mr. Pankaj Chohalia, you may proceed with your question.
Yes, sir, on the import substitution for the lighting and TV business.
Yeah, so on the lighting now, window lighting, the space in which we operate, practically everything is being manufactured in India.
Okay.
And that's the reason for a significant push in our volume as well.
Okay, and battens, you were saying?
So battens, again, which were being imported, the duty has been increased from 10% to 20%, which is leading to the brands looking at domestic India manufacturing, and most of it through outsourcing route.
Okay. Okay. And so on the TV side...
Sorry to interrupt, Pankaj. All the participants are basically requested to limit their questions to two per participant so that
I will come back in the queue.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We have the next question from the line of Rahul Ranade from Goldman Sachs. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Thanks for the opportunity. Just a couple of questions. So the first one, the ODM percentage in lighting seems to have gone up quite significantly over, say, even the June quarter. Just wanted your comments on that.
Yeah, so now everything, all the LED bulbs that we are supplying to all the brands, including Philips, is our design. It's our ODM solutions. So this is what has happened.
Okay.
And now, even on the batten side, even for Philip, the solutions are Dixon solutions, all ODM. And also the solutions, of course, that we'll be offering to other brands in batten are going to be Dixon's design. So a large portion of our lighting business, except for the business of outdoor and indoor drivers of Philip, is going to be ODM.
Okay. Shouldn't that, you know, kind of start reflecting in the margins then? As in, the margins have gone down even sequentially. So, just wanted to understand that.
Yeah, I feel so definitely. We will have that kind of situation. Please appreciate Q2 has been a very typical kind of quarter. So, wherein there has been a very significant volatility of the currency and commodity. So, I feel that in medium term, there has to be an improvement in the margins.
Okay. And just one more question. So, I was just looking at, you know, data, trying to calculate the implied pricing growth for some of the segments that have been disclosed. So, we have disclosed the volume data, which is kind of, and have taken the top line, so the revenue growth for the segment. So, just peculiar for the consumer electronics segment, actually, even on a YOY basis, an implied pricing or implied realization kind of thing seems to have gone down quite significantly, like 25-30%. So, I wanted to understand what is happening over there.
Yeah, so what you're saying is right. The pricing in television has gone down, which you have captured. It has gone down. Now, the pricing of a television is linked to the pricing of open cells, which contributes almost 65% of the bill of material. And in the higher sizes, even higher. So the open cell pricing has been under pressure lately, which is reflecting in BOM coming down. And also the pricing coming down. But in Dixon's case, please appreciate 90% of our business is the EMS business. So there is no pricing impact on us. Our mandate and our strategy is very, very simple. To build the scale, to book the capacity, to deepen the manufacturing, and improve our margins. That's what we are doing. And migrate also to ODM, but in television's case in a very calibrated way, because we just cannot, we do not have the bandwidth first, and it's a high working capital business, so we will not take the chances there. So the migration to ODM in television is going to be in a much more calibrated way. A large portion of our television business would continue to be in EMS. For example, Xiaomi, the large account that we have got, or Skyworth, or Mets, or PCL, they're all conversion businesses, wherein the objective is to improve the margins through scale and through deepening of manufacturing route.
Yeah, sure. So, no, just thinking about it, as in, this cost, since it's going to be passed on, and since this cost goes down, the margins effectively will go up just, you know, by the cost going down, right, of the main
component. As a percentage, yes. As a percentage.
That's right.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Akash Mangani from BOI AXA Investment. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for taking my question. I think a repetitive of one of the earlier questions to start with. You said the lighting margins should come back in spite of this ODM as a percentage increasing. And you said that the reason was the depreciation in the currency and the raw material. So how soon do you think we should come back to what we were clocking in Q1 or what your guidance was earlier?
So I think that's a slightly difficult question, but I feel that from Q4 of this year,
mm-hmm.
it should be coming back to the level at which we were. That's what I feel.
So that should be at Q1's margin level, around 7.5?
Somewhere around that. 7.2, 7.5.
Yeah, guys, that should be at around Q1 level. Also, what is happening on the lighting side, apart from this currency pressure, we're also expanding our capacities in battens and downlighters, which should also help us improving our margins. And of course, the customers that we have added towards the end of second quarter, we'll have a full quarter running for them for quarter three and quarter four. That should help us improving our margin, because as I keep adding more customers, the whole operating leverage benefits keep coming in. So you will revert to the same level of margins what we have been guiding in Q4.
And on now, since you're doing more of ODM and probably going forward will increase the share, so how does the contract pricing work? It takes, what, 1 month, 3 months, or 6 months to pass on any commodity or currency shift? On an average, if you could give some...
So in lighting, with our largest customer, is on monthly basis.
Okay.
With the other customers, you have to go back to them and renegotiate. So there is some lag always, but we have to go back to them and renegotiate. Now, when we're talking about margin improvement in Q4, it is primarily because of three reasons. One, the operating leverage coming in because of the scale in LED bulbs. Second, now we are getting into the higher wattage bulbs, which is 20 watts plus, 20, 30, 40, 50, where obviously the margin is significantly higher. Third, the batten ramp-up, which I think will start getting executed from Q4. So these three reasons should help us in improving the margins.
Okay. The other question is on the washing machine business. Over here, I think one of the earlier calls you mentioned that there is a plan to do something on the fully automatic side as well. So any update on that?
So on the fully automatic, we are still in the conceptualization and the study phase. Concrete plans are still not on the table. We are still in the study mode.
Okay. So the new products that you're talking of from Samsung's fold over the next 12 to 18 months is all on semi-automatic?
Yeah. Because please appreciate 65 to 70% of the market in India is still semi-automatic.
Right.
And that's where the space is for outsourcing. A fully automatic, most of the brands are doing it from their own factories at present.
Okay. And also
could you... So please request you to come back in the queue. Participants, you are requested to restrict your questions to two per participant. The next question is from the line of Rishabh Potra from Sharekhan Limited. Please go ahead.
Hello, sir. Just wanted to understand... what is our capacity utilization ex Tirupati plant, and how much volume or turnover can we do in each of the verticals at full capacity, and what time frame it will take?
So in our Tirupati plant, we are running two product categories. One is LED television. At present, the capacity is around 200K per month. That is 2.4 million. It is going to be expanded to 3.4 million in the next 3 months. What we have executed in the month of October is around 160K. So that's where we are.
That is the peak capacity utilization in the month of October. Sometime in the month of September also we did around 150-155K. The other product category that we are into, so as far as the value and turnover is concerned, I am requesting Saurabh to come back to you separately on that. On the CCTV side, that is both the cameras as well as the DVRs, the capacity has now been ramped up to 500K cameras per month and 150K DVRs per month. The order book for the complete quantity is there with us. And the challenges at present is of ramp-up, which I feel is going to stabilize in the month of November, December. I think from December, January onwards, we should be at around 350K, 400K per month and 100K of DVRs per month. So order book is not a challenge there again. As far as the value is concerned, I am requesting Saurabh to come back to you on this separately, that what revenues will be generated. But please appreciate that the revenues in this case is more of a pass-through.
Okay. And excluding Tirupati, I mean the existing capacities, how much can we scale up or increase the revenue by?
So, we have five verticals now.
Right.
Now, I feel that as far as lighting is concerned, we should be clocking a revenue of around 80 to 90 crores a month. Right. Televisions depends upon which sizes, which brand, what value, and it's a pass-through most of it, 90%.
Okay.
Same is the case in CCTV, DVR. Same is the case in mobile. In washing machine, I feel that we should be clocking a turnover around 25 to 30 crores a month. And from January onwards, it's going to increase to around 35 crores a month. From maybe June onwards, it should increase to around 40, 45 crores a month. And that's practically the ODM business. So,
okay. Yeah. And lastly, sir, do we have any obsolete inventories also because of technical shift and any disputed accounts in terms of receivables?
So, we have a hawk's eye on our inventory and we keep taking adequate provisions. This is an extremely important point, the current asset point, which our audit committee is specifically focused upon. So, please be rest assured, and there is some obsolescence which has been taken care of and will be taken care of in future. In as far as the debtors are concerned, we have already provided for the bad debts. At present, there is some litigation with one of the customers, but for a small amount, it's not a very large amount at all.
Okay. So these are put together will be less than 0.5% of sales or so?
Yeah, this would be much more.
Yeah. The total amount would be, I mean, on the data side, would be around 50-60 lakhs.
Okay. I will come back in queue again.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nikhil Gara from AMSEC. Please go ahead.
Hi. So my first question is regarding in washing machines, can you give us an average sort of number for the customers, as in how much time frame in which the contracts get renewed? If there's an average number you can give.
The contracts are renewed. Sorry, I'm not able to get the question.
So, basically, based on different customers that we have, can we just sort of quantify what would be the renewal cycle? Like you said, for like 6 months, 12 months for different customers. So, is there any average number you can give on that?
So, then most of the customers, it's 1 month.
Okay.
The mechanism for passing on the impact of the currency on the polymer.
Uh-huh.
With one customer, it's 3 months.
Okay.
And with one customer, it's 6 months.
Okay. Okay. My second question would be on regarding Xiaomi. Is there any specific, so first of all, does the margins vary across screen size? And if so, is there any specific screen size where we are getting higher orders from Xiaomi?
So the margins vary from size to size.
Uh-huh.
At present, what we are doing for them is 43 inches.
Okay.
And very shortly, we'll be doing for them 50, 55, and then 32 also.
Okay, got it. So, and one last question regarding lighting business. So is there any ballpoint number you can give for the orders that we get from Crompton, as in what percentage it would be of our overall book?
So Crompton at present is not buying from us.
Okay.
Crompton was our customer. At present, they're not buying from us.
So how much it was, you know, if we could say from 1Q, 2Q, previous orders?
No, for us, the share of Crompton business is very insignificant. Very, very insignificant.
Okay, sir. Thank you. That's it from my side. Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Shreyans Jain from Renaissance Investment Manager. Please go ahead.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
So just wanted to ask you, the ministry released a notification where they're saying they want to set up a manufacturing ecosystem for electronics and electronic components. So just wanted to understand on the longer term, how big could this opportunity be for us?
You see, please appreciate that Indian imports of electronics is humongous. It is just next to the crude. And Government of India very correctly in its policy framework has announced the phased manufacturing programs and created a differential duty structure for incentivizing the manufacturing, the complete value chain in the electronics products in India. Apart from that, there are various other policy initiatives. It was MCEPs, that is expiring December 31st, but I'm sure that something, some other alternative is going to come in. And a new electronics policy is already in place. So I think the government is committed. Industry is almost ready. Obviously, everything takes time. But I think in next 3 to 5 years, India is going to be a very major electronics manufacturing hub globally. You see, because apart from China and now Vietnam emerging, India is going to be a very, very major hub. One, it has a very large domestic market.
Yes.
Second, China costs are increasing. Third, the way the global trade is happening, many, many buyers, large purchasers are looking at India as an alternative. As I shared with you in my opening remarks, that we are having a significant traction in a lighting because we know that we are globally one of the most competitive. As far as the scale is concerned, in indoor lighting and LED bulbs, we would be amongst the top 5 manufacturers globally as far as volume is concerned. So I think that's what we are heading for.
Okay. All right, sir. That was it. Thank you.
Thank you. We have the last question from the line of Rishabh Poza from Sharekhan Limited. Please go ahead.
Hello. Just wanted to further ask, we are not into, as of now, into the refurbished category, and all our products manufactured are original, be it the raw materials are also original parts only.
Yeah.
And for how many clients are we the sole supplier, I mean, all the products we manufacture for our clients?
Phones, is it?
Yeah, phones, I mean, in each of the category. Let's say for Samsung, he only sources products from us. He doesn't have any other vendor to supply products. So are we sole supplier for any of the categories in any of the segments?
So let me just share with you. Like Samsung, Dixon is the only partner.
Okay.
As far as washing machine is concerned.
Yeah.
Xiaomi, Dixon is the only partner as far as TV is concerned. Panasonic, Dixon is the only partner for TV, for washing machines, for mobile phones, and almost 80% of their bulk requirement. For Skyworth, for TCL, for BPL, Flipkart, we are the only partner. Philips, almost 80% of their indoor lighting is only through Dixon. So I think across all the categories, either we are the only partner, or we have a very dominant share. For example, the new customer that we acquired in Bajaj, I think a very large chunk of Bajaj's requirement of indoor lighting is now through only Dixon.
Okay. So just to further dwell on this point, do they play an important role in raw material procurement for us? Because we are catering most of the product for them. I mean, or Dixon does the negotiation himself?
So, raw material side. No, the raw material pricing and sourcing is decided by us.
Okay.
But when we're getting the product approved and the technical approvals,
right.
We have to finalize certain critical components, usually.
Okay.
Not the pricing, the technical specification.
Right. The quality part.
Yeah, the technical specification, the quality norms, yeah.
So the customer doesn't provide us any of the raw material sides?
No.
And lastly, sir, how many client interaction are we engaged with as of now, which can be bought into the board for further manufacturing of products and services in each of the verticals? Let's say fresh addition of a client or a client adding new product for us, which can flow through in next 2-3 quarters, and size of
so
the
that's same. That's a continuous exercise.
Okay.
And across all the verticals, the traction, and let me assure you, the new customer acquisition will be very, very heady.
Okay. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. That was the last question of this conference. I would now like to hand the conference over to Ms. Bhumika Nair for closing comments.
On behalf of IDFC Securities, I would like to thank the management for taking time out and giving us an opportunity to host the call. And thank you to all the participants for being on the call. Thank you very much and wish you all the best.
Thanks very much, everyone. Thank you, Bhumika. Thank you.